All right, so let's kick this off by learning a little bit about sine and cosine. So if you're not familiar with this, this will be a great lecture for you because we're going to take a look at why sine and cosine are very important when you're creating patterns, especially a chain link fence pattern like we're creating here. All right, so let's dive into Houdini and take a look. All right, so let's get our chain link pattern started by learning a little bit about sine and cosine and how we can use them here inside of Houdini to modify the shape of a line. Okay, so what I'm going to do is drop down a geometry node here. I'm going to call this the chain link generator, like so. Cool. And inside of here, what I'm going to do is I'm going to drop down a line. And this line is basically going to be the basis for our chain link pattern. All right. Might not seem like it right now, but it will become that here pretty soon. All right, so what I'm going to do is I'm going to point this guy straight up in Y. So I'm going to get rid of all my defaults that I had set up. All right, so this is basically what we're looking for. And what we need to do is we need to go and add a couple more points so we can actually see the effects of using sine and cosine here. All right, so what I want to do at this point, now that I have a bunch of points, all right, I'm going to drop down a wrangle node here. And we're going to feed in the output of our line into the first input of our attribute wrangle node. And we're going to set it so that we run over all the points, because what I want to do is for each one of these points, all right, I want to move it in 3D space using sine and cosine. All right. And sine and cosine basically are the components that allow you to build a circle with all these points. So to just put it plainly, if you combine sine and cosine together, what you can do is you can build a circle out of a line. All right. So the way it works is if we come in here and we say at p dot x, all right, because I'm going to just worry about just the cosine currently. So let's hit 3 on the keyboard and go to the front viewport. So what I want to say is that, let me actually turn the line back on here so we have something to look at here. Cool. What I want to do is I want to say that our x position, currently our x position is 0 right now on each of these points, all right. I want to say that our x position is equal to, let's say, the cosine of our y position for each one of those points. All right, so let's take a look at that. And look at that, we get some sort of curve here. All right, it's really just one portion of a circle. All right, and so what we're doing is we're literally taking in our current y position and just feeding it into the cosine function here. So if we come back up to our line before we modified it, all these values, or the y value for each one of these points, goes from 0 all the way up to 1, right? Because our line has a length of 1. All right, so this point 0 is a value of 0. And we could actually visualize what the y value is over here. All right, if we put in some sort of attribute. So if I say something like f at y val, all right, so we're creating our own attribute on our points here, is equal to at p dot y, and that's the y position of each point. So if we come down here now into the geometry spreadsheet, you can see that each one of those points now has a y value. So what we're doing is we're feeding in that value into that cosine value. All right, super cool. All right, so let's take a look at some more useful techniques here. So if I were to, let's say, multiply this, let's just say times 2, and we need to put in the 2. There we go. We increase that curve. Now it's starting to look like some sort of function graph or something like that. All right. And at this point, that's not exactly what I'm looking for. I want to create some sort of smooth ramped curve. Okay. And so to do that, I need to come in here and say dollar pi. All right. That's a global variable for the value pi, or 3.14. And I want to multiply that by 2 times our at p dot y. And look at that. We now get the full circle. All right, because pi times 2 basically is 360 degrees. All right, but this will give us 6.2 in radians. All right, but you convert that to degrees, you'll get 360 degrees. And then we're basically just mapping that based off the y position of each point. All right, so hopefully that makes sense. Let me know if not. All right, so now that we've got that value going, let's go back to our perspective view and hit 1 on the keyboard. And you can see that, you know, it looks like it's spiraling around. If we were coming into that front view again, it looks like it's kind of spiraling around. Well, we could actually create a full circle out of this. We can go and say at p dot z is equal to the sine of that same value. So pi times 2, or 360 degrees, and take our at p dot y value. And look at that. we now have a perfect spiral, perfect circle. So if we were to move all of our y value from here now, well, actually, we need a wrangle value down here. And we're going to say at p dot y equals 0. Look at that, perfect circle. All right, so hopefully that helps clear things up a little bit for sine and cosine. Very powerful stuff. All right, and we're going to use it to create our chain link pattern. So I'm going to close out the lecture there. And in the next lecture, we are going to get our pattern going. Thanks so much.